आई डोंट नो वेयर टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम। हेलो गाइस, आई एम मोना प्रिंस एंड टुडे वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द मलयालम फिल्म अय्यप्पनम कोशियम, रिटन एंड डायरेक्टेड बाय साची, स्टारिंग पृथ्वीराज सुकुमार, बिजू मेनन एंड मेनी मोर। जस्ट बिफोर मेकिंग दिस वीडियो आई गॉट टू नो दैट साची, ऑल्सो नोन एज कोवाकट्टू आर सचिदानंदन, इज नो मोर। ही पास्ड अवे इन जून। ही हैड सो मच मोर टू गिव एंड इट्स रियली सैड। रेस्ट इन पीस। So talking about the film, I want to know where this idea came from, like why, like, you know, how this even came to existence, who thought of it? Of course I know who thought of it, but how? Because I freaking love this film. What a film. What I knew going into this film is that it is a character drama, and it was that. The writing was fabulous, so good. The tension was so much. It was just a small event. From there, how the story formed, how things happened, the ripple effects of it. The whole film was a seesaw ride. At no moment the tension dropped. It just kept increasing. Being a 3-hour film, that's an amazing screenplay right there. The way table turns after the interval. So guys, if you find value in this video, do hit that like button, because when you do that, YouTube promotes this video and more people can watch it. Also consider subscribing and hit that bell icon to get notification whenever a new video drops. From such a small event, how things can just explode, what male ego can lead to. Due to that toxic masculinity that was instilled in Koshi through his dad, all of this is the result of that. That man's respect is greater than a human life. The power play juggle, the politics of it, you know, the connections, having that influence. Now Appan Nair will not take this and show everyone their aukat. It just keeps getting messy and messy, the situations one after the other making it more complex. And it all happens organically. It never feels that it is forced, so the narrative goes ahead. It all feels natural. And I think what makes this a great film is the authenticity of the film. The police procedural, the laws, the rules. How the narrative is just woven through all the laws. Every situation, there's some law or the other that's just, you know, increasing the tension, creating the situations, making it logical, real and reasonable, and in turn making it interesting. Because whatever you are, whoever you are, you cannot change these rules. Even if you're a hero, if you have so much influence, you cannot. You have to, you know, abide by them. These are irreversible actions, thus increasing the tension. That is what I was talking about in my Lucifer Your Vente Pushtigam video. You can check it out here. I also love that the characters were grey. There was no good or bad. It was not a good versus evil fight, not at all. It was just male egos clashing, colliding, trying to be the one on top. In the beginning, when we just see the police, you know police is dangerous. Don't mess with them. And we already like, oh, why am I messing with, now you're gone. But looking at Koshi, we see there's something to him. He's arrogant, he has something, you know, he's hiding, he has some power. And then that power comes in, he has connection with politicians, producers, police officials. And how the, you know, the seesaw starts, the power shifts to him. And now we are worried for Appan, because he is so strong, he has so much influence. And at the interval, the table turns. And we see what he can do, now that he is not restrained by the law. Even the place and the setting, they added so much to the story. The elephants in that jungle, that can be a metaphor for Ayappan. Because Koshi passed through that forest, where it's advised that don't go there, wild animals are there, elephants cross, take care. Don't come in the path of an elephant, which Koshi does. I love this film, but definitely there are some issues too. It's not a perfect film at all. I think the first thing is that they went overboard with the camera work, which leads to some inconsistency throughout the film. Attaching cameras to props which are falling or moving when the house falls down. And there's so many experimental shots like this that they are not consistent throughout the film enough, and it just breaks the consistency. And that creates problems for the editing too, because you need to add those shots which are not needed, and the editing also becomes very choppy. There were some sequences like, I didn't understand what happened. There were a lot of continuity errors. One shot ended somewhere and the next shot started before that shot even completed. So there was all of these issues which I noticed, and because I noticed, I have to talk about it. There was a lot of spoon feeding going on in the film, which I didn't like at all. In the beginning when we see that ritual, and in the middle of the film when we are told by C.I. Satish that Ayappan is Mundur Madan, I think that was enough. But there were again so many dialogues that him telling Koshi he can do this, he can do that, don't come into the grip of him and all of that. Just basically too much spoon feeding going on. And even with the background music, whenever there were some funny scenes, the background music changed and it became a funny music. It was not needed at all because it was situational comedy. Without that music telling me it's a funny scene, I would have understood it's a funny scene. I would have laughed on it. But just because, you know, you're telling me it's a funny scene, it loses its charm. Now, I don't think there's a scene that should be removed from the film. I don't think so at all. But I have to agree that the film is exhaustive because I felt exhaustion at the end of the film. It felt like this is just going forever and I have, you know, no answer for it. I don't know what could have been done right, so that was not the feeling we get. Maybe a two-part film, maybe a series instead of a movie, I don't know. But I felt exhaustion, so I have to tell you that. Coming to a problematic scene in the film where Koshi slaps his wife. I've been discussing about this scene in the Discord. Go join it, link in the description. We didn't come to an answer, but definitely for me that scene is problematic because I understand Koshi is not a gentleman. His character is like that, who would slap his wife. He has that male ego, he has the patriarchy in him, so I understand that as a character he would slap his wife. But why? Before he slaps her, the wife questions the father, Kurian, and we feel that he slapped because she disrespected him. But no, he's like, why you didn't do that before? And it feels like it is supposed to be an empowering moment for the women. But it's not. It's definitely not. And that's why it's a problematic scene. If he had slapped her because she was disrespecting his father, that would have actually made sense character-wise. But that's not the motive of that scene. And that motive of the scene is bigger than the character itself. That scene is there to give a message to the audience. But it doesn't work at all. It's a very problematic scene. It's not about the character slapping her. It's about the intention of the makers. What are they trying to show with that scene? And that doesn't go out well. And in the last shot of the film, when he comes to his house and both of them shake hands, that scene was not needed at all. I didn't like it. I don't know why they did that. Let me know in the comments if you know, but I didn't like that scene. I think they should have not met each other and that's where the movie should have ended. That's it. There was no need of this conclusion. Talking about the acting, Prithviraj Sukumar, you have earned a fan in me. I just loved your performance and I'm a fan now. I've seen him in Mumbai Police and I can definitely see the growth in his acting. He just played this character flawlessly. I always felt he's Koshi, he's no one else. He was totally into the character. The way he carried that arrogance, the male ego, even he got vulnerable when he was scared, and it was just a fabulous performance. Biju Menon was amazing. He was holding on his own. There was a very strong performance by Prithviraj, but he was there and equally supported the film. And the relationship between these two had to be really, really good for the film to work. It all depended on that. Kurian's character played by Ranjit, I really liked his character. Some people told me that he was not fleshed out, but I feel whatever he had, that was enough to understand what his character is. The way he treats his son, what he thinks, he has been to jail. There are hints of his character throughout the film, and that is enough to make him a three-dimensional character. Kanamma, played by Gauri Nanda, she was really, really good, whatever small role she had. And I think most of the cast did really, really well. I know there were some non-actors in the film, and some places I did notice something off, but it was alright. I was so focused on the film that I didn't care. So guys, that's it. Just love this film. What an amazing writing and screenplay. Something to study. So guys, thank you for watching this video. If you like this, thumbs up, share this video. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed yet, check out the videos. And if you like them too, do consider subscribing. And I'll see you next time. Stay home, stay safe.